Alright guys, and welcome back, and today I have another tech tip for you, and this is a pretty common one, and it's how to install a CLI dump. So the things you're going to need is Betaflight, your drone, and let's hop right into it. Now the first thing you're going to want to do is find your CLI dump, and you can find that at our knowledge base. And the easiest way to get to that is to go to EMAX USA, and you're gonna go to customer support. And once you're at customer support, you're gonna scroll down and it's gonna say EMAX knowledge base, manuals, CLI dumps, and more. So go ahead and hit explore now. Now once you're in our knowledge base section, you're gonna go ahead and find the drone that you have. For me, I'm using our Tiny Hawk 2. It could be any drone though. So if you're using a Freestyle, the Tiny Hawk, Tiny Hawk S, make sure you go to that section, and that's where you're gonna find your manual and your CLI dump. So I'm gonna scroll down and look for Tiny Hawk 2. So once you're at this link, you're gonna find the manuals, the firmwares, what kind of Betaflight you should be running. Make sure that you're running the correct Betaflight, and also make sure you're on the correct firmware. If it's a brand new one from the factory, you're already gonna be on the correct firmware it says. So all we're gonna have to do is download and install the CLI dump. So I'm gonna look for the CLI dump that fits my drone specific. So if you have a BNF, you're gonna wanna download the BNF CLI, and if you have an RTF, you're gonna wanna install that one. So I'm working with the BNF model, so I'm gonna look for that one, click that, and download that. So once you click the link, you're gonna see that the CLI command pops up on your computer. Now we're gonna have to either copy this or we're gonna download it so we can transfer it over to Betaflight. So the easiest way to do it is to go ahead and hit the download arrow up top, and that's gonna download it to your computer. Now once you have the CLI command downloaded, we're gonna open up Betaflight and connect our drone to Betaflight, and we're gonna install that CLI command onto our Tiny Hawk 2 or whatever other model you may have. Now, once you have Betaflight open, you're gonna go ahead and connect your drone with the USB cable, and make sure this is a data transfer one and not just a charging cable. The one that comes in the Ready to Fly kit will transfer data, but if you bought a Bind and Fly, you're gonna have to supply your own. So I went ahead and connected my drone to Betaflight, and you can see up top that it connected to a USB modem. I'm working on a Mac, so it's gonna say that. If you're working on a PC, it's gonna say some kind of COM port. So after you connected your USB cable, you're gonna go ahead and hit connect on Betaflight. Now once you're connected, it's gonna open right up to the setup page. The next thing you'll do is you'll go down to the CLI tab, and it's right on the left. You can see it's the last tab on Betaflight. Now that we click that, we're in the CLI command bar, and this is where we're going to install the command we just downloaded. You're going to go ahead and hit load from file. Once I hit load from file, a window is going to pop up and ask me, what do I want to install in here? And mine just downloaded to downloads, so I'm going to find that right here. And you can see that it says Tiny Hawk BNF, so that's the one that I want to install. So I'm going to click that and hit open. Now a window is going to open asking you if you want to execute the command. You're going to go ahead and hit execute, and the command is going to start uploading to your drone. This may take a few seconds, so be patient and let the command finish, and once it's done, it's going to save and reboot your drone. And then after that, you can go ahead and disconnect your drone. Now keep in mind, you may have to rebind your drone, so if you plug it in and nothing's happening, go ahead and try to rebind. Go back to our knowledge base, you can find all the binding instructions there. But that's pretty much it on how to upload your CLI command. Hopefully this video made that process a little bit easier for you. And if you like this type of content, make sure to hit that subscribe and notification bell. And let us know in the comments what kind of videos you want to see next. If you got any more tech related questions, or if you want to see some of our new products that are coming out soon. But until the next one guys, I'll catch you later.